The Public Education Department came under fire recently, mainly because of controversial teacher evaluations. Action 7 News reporter Regina Reese explains how a different kind of fire, gunfire, has the police investigating.
The sound of gunshots left on a voicemail message at the Public Education Department.
We sent an officer over there to start investigating that, because with this day and age, you have to take, you know, all these kind of situations seriously, and we do look into them.
That wasn't the only threat to PED.
State police say after that gunshots message, another call came in the very next day. It was a male caller, and he made specific threats to a PED employee.
When the phone was picked up, you know, the individual started talking and made some threatening or some scary threats towards that individual.
The calls came in mid-October. Right now, state police are investigating who left this message. A perceived threat for the State Department in charge of education.
We're currently trying to get the call logs so that we can see if we could trace those phone calls and see if we could identify them with someone.
But until police track down the caller, PED is taking extra precautions.
We had advised them just to hang up their security, have one entry, one exit point to the building, and just monitor who's there and keep track of who's coming in and out.
If police do track down whoever made the calls, it's considered phone harassment, which is a crime.
And phone harassment is a misdemeanor.